Hello friends, welcome to another ESP32 Home Automation project. Here I have to connect the smartphone with the same Wi-Fi network where ESP32 is connected. Then I will open the browser, then tap on this link to open the dashboard. Now from this dashboard, I can easily control the appliances with my smartphone. Here the smartphone is connected with the Wi-Fi router, so the total range for this project will depend on the Wi-Fi router, not ESP32. And you can also control the appliances manually with switches or push button and monitor the real-time feedback on the dashboard. And the best part of this project, you can activate or deactivate the EEPROM from the dashboard. To activate the EEPROM, I will just tap on this button. And also the blue LED is on, so EEPROM is activated. Now let me turn on the first two relays. Now let me turn off the complete supply. ESP32 don't have any power supply right now. Let me turn on the supply again. And you can see the first two lamp automatically turns on when the power comes back. So these are very useful features. You can activate or deactivate the EEPROM from the dashboard. And you can also control the appliances from multiple smartphone, laptop, if it connected with the same Wi-Fi network. So this is a very useful project. During the video, I have explained all the steps. Although you can make the circuit without using any PCB, but to make the circuit compact, I have designed this PCB using the Altium PCB Designer software. This video is sponsored by Altium, which is the most trusted PCB designer software by all the big electronic companies. With Altium, you can easily search for components, compare the datasheet, and it has a lot of useful features that will save you a lot of time while routing any complex PCB. Now Altium has come up with an amazing product called Altium 365. Altium 365 is an electronic product design platform that unites PCB design, MCAD, data management, and teamwork. With Altium 365, you can not only design PCBs, you can also share your projects with your teammates for review. It also provides automatic backup, centralized cloud storage, and a lot more. There are many tutorials available on Altium, so you can easily learn this software and use it to design professional PCBs. And you can download the Altium Designer free trial with Altium 365 from the link in the description. Afterwards, if you decide to purchase the software, you will get 25% off if you have signed up through my link. So please visit the link in the description, sign up for the Altium. It's a limited time offer, so please hurry up. To make this project, you just need an ESP32, 4-channel relay module, switches or push button, then connect all these components as per the circuit diagram. In the circuit, I have connected these switches across the GPIO pins and ground. And here I have used active low relay module. So the relay will turn on for the low signal in the control pin. And if you want to use push button, then you can refer to this circuit. Again, the push buttons are connected across the GPIO pins and ground. Now we will move to coding part of this project. These are the source codes for this project. You can download these codes from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the related article. You can find the link in the description. Then you can download the codes from this button. And in that same article, I also explained the complete code line by line. So if you have any query, you can always refer to this same article. You can find the link in the description. Now after downloading, here you can see this is the code for the button. If you want to use push button for manual control, then you can refer this code. Here you can see button in the code name. And this is the code for the latch switch. Here I am going to upload this code with latch switch. So let me open it with Arduino IDE. Now let me connect the ESP32 with my laptop to upload this code. For this project, I have used this version of the ESP32 and you have to install this library. Here you can also see these libraries I have used for this project. Then these GPIOs are connected with the relay control pin. Here I have used active low relay module. Then these GPIOs are connected with the switches. Then here you can see this is the IP. Using this IP we can access the web dashboard. And here I have to enter the SSID, which is Wi-Fi name, and the Wi-Fi password. Now let me go to the void setup. here you can see, first I am defining the broad grid, then we are connecting with the Wi-Fi with the fixed IP, and here you can see with the pin mode function we are defining the output and input pin. Then in the void loop with this line we are checking if any request coming from the client. Then using this block we are checking if any manual button press. Accordingly we are calling this function to control the relays. Then this is the HTML content for the web dashboard, and here I have used JavaScript JSON to get real-time feedback, and I have also used CSS to make the dashboard more attractive with color. And these are the function for the web dashboard. Using this we are controlling the relay, then using this we are handling the all off button in the dashboard. Then we are changing the EEPROM status flag using this, and we are showing the real-time status using this function. So if you go through the code you can easily understand. Still if you have any query you can always refer to the article, you can find the link in the description. Now let me go to tools, select the proper board and COM port, then hit the upload button. After programming the ESP32, let me turn on the supply. Now I will connect with the same Wi-Fi network where ESP32 is connected. Here you can see I have connected with the same network. Now I will open the Google Chrome. Then I will enter the fixed IP http://192.168.1.100. I will tap here to open the dashboard. Currently all the relays are off, so here it is showing all the relays are off. Let me turn on the relays one by one. Currently all the relays are on, and I can use this button to turn off all the relays together. Now let me control the relays with manual switches, and you can monitor the real-time feedback on the dashboard. Now let me turn off the relays one by one. Now let me turn on the EEPROM restore. I will just tap this button to turn it on, and as soon as I activate the EEPROM, the blue LED turns on. Now let me turn on the first two relays. First two relays are on. Now let me turn off the supply for the ESP32. ESP32 do not have any power supply right now. Now let me give the supply again, and as soon as the power comes back, the first two relay automatically turns on as the EEPROM is showing active. Now let me turn off the EEPROM. I will just tap here to turn it off. Here you can see it is showing off, and the blue LED also turn off. Now let me turn on the third relay. Currently first three relays are on and EEPROM is not active. Again let me turn off the supply for the ESP32. Now let me give the supply again. As the EEPROM is not active, so no relays turn on automatically after the powers come back. So this is a very useful project you can easily make. So if you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.